Greetings and blessings upon you all. Welcome to Faith Chapel Presbyterian Church's worship. Way back in the beginnings of Faith Chapel, they worshiped beneath a tree. And so we gather together today to worship simply and wonderfully. So bring yourselves together, gather in, and prepare thyselves to worship our Lord.
Watch and wait for Christ's coming. Like candles of hope, peace, joy, and love. Remembering the promises of God with prayer. We have lit the candle of hope, and now we light the candle of peace. Hear God's promise of peace from Isaiah chapter 11, verse 1 through 10. A shoot shall come out of the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together. And a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain. For the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious. Let us pray. Faithful God, you are at work to restore all of creation in its intended harmony. Give us your shalom, that we may be reconciled to all enemies in the peace that passes all understanding, through Christ Jesus our Lord. God of promise, God of hope, into our darkness come. Come, let us worship our Lord.
The reign of God is drawing near. The prophet calls us to change our lives. Prepare the way for the Lord. A just and peaceful path. Welcome one another, for Christ welcomes you, for the glory of God. Holy God, we long for your peace and trust in your promise. We hear your call to turn toward you, to change our lives, and welcome you in. Meet us here and fill our minds with your wisdom and our hearts with your peace, that our worship together may open us to the challenge of your dream of wholeness for all. In the name of the one who is coming, we pray. Amen. John the Baptist prepares the way. In the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, Herod, tetrarch of Galilee, his brother Philip, tetrarch of Iturea and Trachonitis, and Lysanias, tetrarch of Abilene, during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas. The word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. He went into all the country around the Jordan, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. As it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill made low. The crooked road shall become straight, the rough ways smooth, and all people will see God's salvation. This is the word of our Lord.
Do you remember when? It's kind of a game that as you get older, you play this game called Do You Remember When? You have to have some age to you because it requires for the world around you to change before you can play a good game of Do You Remember When? So let's play that game. Do you remember when? Now, for some of you, you'll be able to engage rather well with this. For others, you may very well scratch your head and go, "What on earth are they talking about?" It's okay. There's a reason. So, do you remember when there were no cell phones? Some of you are going, "Yep, yeah, I remember." Others of you may be going, "Kind of, but I was too young to really remember." And others of you going, "No, I don't remember that." I'm of the age of, yes, I remember very well when we didn't have cell phones. So, since I'm of that age of before the cell phone, let me share with you a bit of what I remember it being like and see if maybe you agree. I remember not having it carried around in my back pocket. I remember not having it stuffed in a coat pocket or clipped onto my belt. I remember not constantly having it in my hand. The phone. One of the ways in which we communicate the most, still to this day, but yet it's different. I remember when, in order to know if someone called you, you would have to either be home, in your home, near the phone, or you would have to wait until you got home and went inside your home. And if you were lucky enough, you had an answering machine that would tell you that the person had called. You would hit the button and hear their voice, and yeah, they called. Now that's a lot of waiting to be done. And in this day and age where we have cell phones that are attached to our hands, it can kind of make you go, "Oh, wow. You had to wait that long to find out if somebody called you?" It required a patience of us that we didn't even know we needed because it was just the way it was. Now, do you also remember when your phone actually hung on the wall and that it had this handset? Oh, look. The cell phone's gone. It had this handset that you held up like this with the earpiece and the mouthpiece, and attached to the end of it was a cord that reached all the way back up to the wall to the base unit of the phone. The corded telephone. Now, you could have had. At one point in time, the rotary kind where in order to dial a number, you had to stick your finger in the hole and turn it. They were called rotaries. But if you were in the new age, you might have had the push button where you pushed the numbers. But that cord on that phone that hung on the wall, if you had teenagers in the home, that cord grew exponentially the older the teenager got because they would stretch that cord until they could find a private spot to have a conversation with their friends. Do you remember when? Now, a great deal of this might seem like a bit like a comedy sketch, and to my mind, it kind of is. But mostly because I'm getting older. But there is a point to this. Because in our scripture today, God calls John the Baptist forth out of the wilderness to begin to preach a gospel of repentance and forgiveness, and that salvation was coming. Now you got to remember. Remember when in scripture that his father, Zechariah, had gone into the temple and an angel appeared to him and told him that he was going to have a son. And he didn't believe the angel, so the angel struck him mute until his son was born. And that child was John the Baptist. So a patience, a time of waiting. And here we are in these scriptures where the very purpose of that angel's visit comes to fruition. John the Baptist begins his journey out of the wilderness to proclaim salvation's coming. Now, it's a lot of years between that moment in the temple to the time when John is grown and begins that journey. But it was a patience that he didn't know that was needed. And even now, as we're sitting in Advent and we're patiently waiting for Christmas, and we kind of don't have a choice because now we have a set time. It's December 25th. We have to wait until Christmas morning to open our gifts. We have to wait to gather. We have to wait and wait. And we're not good at waiting, so we fill that time with buying and getting and doing and being busy. And in the midst of all that busyness, as the time speeds by us, we forget to remember the very reason of why we're even in this season, of why we are patiently waiting. So yeah, it took a long time for the cell phone to come to be. And don't we use them a lot? And don't they stay attached? And though it may have only taken decades for the cell phone to come to be, the story of Christmas took millennia. And even this day, thousands of years later after Jesus' birth, we're still talking about it. So, do you remember when? Do you remember when you became a believer? Now that's a good game to play. Amen.
They traveled to Bethlehem to seek him.
Holy God, in this season, suspended between hope and fulfillment, let we never forget what you have done. May we be overwhelmed by your mercy, which flows in wave after wave. May we be honest about the darkness within us and perceptive of the light around us. May we make straight the path for the Lord, that together we may see God's glory revealed. We pray in the name of the one who is coming, our Lord, our Savior, Jesus. Amen.